Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sheena Bansal. So today we will talk about osteoporosis. See, firstly, in the osteoporosis fractures firstly will occur at the more chances of fractures in the vertebra, then hip, then distal radius fractures. Maximum chances of fractures are in the vertebra, then hip, then distal radius. Management is done with the mainly bisphosphonates. Bisphosphonates may be are of two types, non-nitrogen containing and nitrogen containing. Non-nitrogen containing works by producing toxic ATP analog, and nitrogen containing inhibit farnesyl pyrophosphate synthase. Then we also have denosumab. Denosumab is the rank ligand antibody like osteoprotegrins, OPG, also used for GCT, that is giant cell tumors. Then we also have teriparatide, which is recombinant hormone, parathyroid hormone, also used for jaw osteonecrosis, whereas bisphosphonates and denosumab can cause jaw osteonecrosis as side effect, whereas teriparatide is used for the treatment. Now, contraindications of teriparatide are if patient is having osteosarcoma, if patient is having Paget's disease, cause Paget's disease can turn into sarcoma if we will give teriparatide. So these are the contraindications. Now we will talk about the sclerostin. What is the sclerostin? Sclerostin is produced by osteocytes and encoded by the SOST gene. Sclerostin is antagonist of WNT pathway, which work for the osteoblast. So von Buschke disease. Now we will talk about the von Buschke disease and endosteal hyperostosis. So sclerostin causes osteoporosis, and von Buschke disease and endosteal hyperostosis are the diseases in which there is decreased expression of SOST, means sclerostin is less in amount, and so we have hyperostosis. Blosozumab and romosozumab can be used for the osteoporosis patients which target the sclerostin. Okay. Now see, we have divided the patient into osteoporosis, osteopenic or normal on the basis of seeing T-score on the DEXA scan. Osteopenia is defined as if you have T-score in between -1 to -2.5, and osteoporosis if less than -2.5. Bisphosphonates and osteoporosis will also be said, but not it will not be said to be diagnostic, but it is not the diagnostic that if vitamin D is less than 20 nanogram per ml. Bisphosphonates causes lateral cortex thickening, localized in areas causing having stress fractures, developing stress fractures. Chief cells produces PTH, parafollicular cells produce calcitonin. Raloxifen is the partial agonist of estrogen receptor. Now, how will we do the management of the osteoporotic patients? See, if the patient is having age more than 50 plus T-score less than -2.5, then we will have to give the treatment with anti-resorptive agents. But if patient is more than 50 and his T-score is -1 to -2.5, then what will we do? We will see the fracture risk assessment score, in which if we have hip fracture risk, 10-year hip fracture risk is more than 3%, and major osteoporotic fracture risk we have more than 20%, देन वी विल गिव द एंटी रिजॉर्प्टिव एजेंट्स, अदरवाइज वी विल नॉट गिव. नाउ वी विल डू डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डिनोसमैब एंड बिस्फोस्फोनेट्स. फर्स्टली बिस्फोस्फोनेट्स बाइंड टू कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्सीएपेटाइट, बट डिनोसमैब डजंट बाइंड. बिस्फोस्फोनेट डजंट अफेक्ट द ऑस्टियोक्लास्ट फॉर्मेशन, बट डिनोसमैब अफेक्ट ऑस्टियोक्लास्ट फॉर्मेशन, सर्वाइवल एंड फंक्शन. बट बिस्फोस्फोनेट्स हैज पीसीपी बैकबोन एंड अफेक्ट ओनली सर्वाइवल एंड फंक्शन बट नॉट फॉर्मेशन. इन द ऑस्टियोपोरोटिक पेशेंट्स व्हाट विल वी डू, वी विल डू, वी हैव टू डू 1000 to 1500 मिलीग्राम ऑफ कैल्शियम डेली एंड 400 to 800 इंटरनेशनल यूनिट्स ऑफ कॉलीकैल्सिफेरॉल और वाइटमिन डी. एंड यू नो टेरीपेराटाइड इज कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड इन, टेरीपेराटाइड इज कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड इन इफ वी हैव कैंसर मेटास्टेसिस, इफ वी हैव पेजेट्स डिसीज, इफ वी हैव ऑस्टियोसारकोमा. इन दीज केसेस इट इज कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड. एंड यू नो बिस्फोस्फोनेट्स इज कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड इन इफ वी हैव गैस्ट्रिक गैस्ट्रिक प्रॉब्लम्स और इसोफेजाइटिस, then bisphosphonates are contraindicated. Then we will prefer giving denosumab.